Color Switch is a casual game, and I made it for what I understand as being the biggest gaming market, which is people with cell phones, and most of those are non-gamers or casual gamers. So I made Color Switch with that audience in mind, hoping I could create something that would have a mass appeal. And Color Switch is a very simple game. Given the fact that I made it for that audience, it has to be very simple. You only tap the screen to play it, and you play as this little ball that will switch between four colors. Whichever color it currently is, that's the color you have to go through these spinning obstacles that are made up of four colors. And that's the whole game, essentially. And there's all sorts of different obstacles, shapes, patterns to go through. And yeah, that's the essence of the game. And I just made it really challenging. So it's really hard, but it's not so hard that you don't feel like you can't get good at it. And yeah, that's Color Switch in a nutshell.
So it sounds like it's grown rapidly, very shortly. Like, how many users do you have now?
Well, we are nearing 100 million. We're not there yet, so I don't want to say that yet, but we are close to that. And that's since December, so it's been about 8 months now. And this is worldwide. The number one app on the Apple App Store over, you know, any kind of app, Facebook, Instagram, whatever. We were number one for about 28 days. And I think we broke the record for a game to be number one that long in the free category. And we went number one in 130 countries. I think over 130 countries. And yeah, even though that was our peak maybe in February or March, we've still stayed consistent with downloads and just people playing it over and over. And I go out, I travel around with my Color Switch shirt on, which I don't have on right now. And I meet people all the time. They get really excited about the game. There's something about it that people just get really excited when I meet them. So if you want to start right away, get in there and start building games quick, you should get a piece of software called BuildBox. And you can get that at buildbox.com. That's what I use to build my game with. And I built the game, the main core of the game, in about 10 minutes, and then I spent about a week building all the levels, so very quick. Aside from that, I would say study, even more important than programming skills, is game design skills. And even today, like I said, I don't program anything. I don't even know how to program. I use BuildBox, which is very simplified software. But because I worked on game design skills, it doesn't matter if I program apps or not. I hire people to program them, and I'm the game designer, and I tell them, I direct them in how they need to build it. So I would say study game design skills, and a book I would recommend is called The Art of Game Design. That's been my go-to book for 2 or 3 years now. The other thing I would say is you have to, if you want to have the ability to think of really good ideas, you have to improve your thought process. And the only way to do that is to keep learning and applying things that will do that. One of the main books that I have used for improving my thought process is called Thinker Toys. And that is a book of creative thinking techniques. Because anything you do in life is a direct result from what you think. And if you just keep doing things without improving your thought process, then you'll never get results that are too different from what you've been doing. So that's what that book is all about. It's all about using these creative thinking techniques to solve your problems in creative ways that you wouldn't have thought of otherwise. And if you do this every day, they're simple to do, you'll gradually improve your results because your thinking gradually improves. And then one day, you're going to find that diamond that you've been looking for that's going to solve the problem in your business or your personal life. And that's going to take you to places that you wouldn't have gone to otherwise. So improving your thought process and studying game design, and get BuildBox. Those would be my main tips.
Okay. But is there one game from your childhood that really inspired you or made you really interested in this game world?
Actually there were a couple things. I've been watching the original Tron ever since I was probably like 3. And I really have always been inspired by that. The visuals, the soundtrack, just the story of being in this computer world. And then I've been playing video games on floppy disks ever since I was 5. I would go to our neighbor's house and they had a computer, and so I'd play one of my all-time favorite games called Load Runner. And to this, so I've been playing games since I was 5, and I just get inspired by Tron and other things. And I think the more you get out there in the world, you can find more things that'll inspire you, which is what I always strive for too. But those are the main things I would say that really inspired me when I was younger.
Okay. Awesome. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for your time, David.
You got it.
Yeah.
Pleasure.
Yeah, thank you so much.